shapeshift, destructive surprise, all that sort of nonsense. You're able to come around, get you guys placed in the box. Looking in this room is this sort of double spheres. You can see the statues and things kind of coming off the wall that are showing signs of souls being kind of pulled into the wall. You can see that on the ground, I'm going to describe the bodies first, there are dozens and dozens of corpses. You can see that in this room, none of the corpses seem to be the gray-robed either angels or gray-robed servants of the City of the Damned. All of the things in here look like they are fey creatures. You can see the bodies of several trolls, several eladrin, and things of that nature that are scattered around. The ones that you see look like they are, like they not only are destroyed, are dead, but they are completely destroyed. They look like they are very, very brittle, like their entire body has been reduced to ash. For those of you guys that were in the adventure Flamewake, you would recognize this effect from Flamewake. Then around the room, there are seven soul caches. Make sure that I'm sharing the correct thing. I am indeed. So, you have the soul cache handout. That's what those things look that are spread around. Six of them are vibrant colors in all colors of the rainbow. One of them is very, very dark. It looks like it is pitch black and almost like it's eating the light in the room around it, the one in the middle of the room. Cool. It is actually a different color. So this one in the middle is very, very dark. And then you see angels that do not seem to have the same sort of library of the others that are slain, that are gathered around. Each of the angels is around one of the soul caches and seems to be drawing power from and in the process destroying these individual soul caches. You see cracks that are starting to break open on the exterior of the soul cache and energy that is leaking from it into the different reapers that are gathered around. The reaper angels that are these ones here look fairly heavily armored. They have long kind of white wings. They look very kind of traditional angel, but each of them is holding an enormous scythe. So kind of the idea of the reaper, but the reaper angels look like angels that are holding onto scythes. The other ones, the sandflow reapers, they don't have the big wings of the angels. They don't have the same sort of angelic type appearance. Although you can tell that there is some sort of angelic power coming from them, they look like dead angels, and you see that there is this aura of flowing sand gathered around them. Each of them holds a smaller scythe in one hand and an hourglass with sand that seems to kind of flow back and forth on the outside and inside of the hourglass in a continuous cycle. You can see that each one of the ones around the room is corrupting one of the individual soul caches, although none of them seem to be paying attention to the center soul cache. As you enter the room, they look like they are obviously going to be engaging you guys as you are interrupting them. The soul caches are labeled on the map in different colors, so red, yellow, blue, pink, white, and green. If you bind yourself to an individual soul cache, please do something either on yourself or we can have like a handout or something for marking which one is yours. In the soul cache handout, if you have any questions, please go ahead and ask me. I'm going to explain one thing really quickly, is the different actions, you can interact with them. You need to make skill checks for those actions. So you can, as a minor action, you can bind yourself to a particular orb to make it easier to protect. You do not have to be near the orb in order to do this. Although interacting with orbs from distance is going to give you some minor penalty. You can also do repair the orb or reinforce an orb to give an additional strike, which will then change the orb, the number for that individual color as a standard action, or you can do something else, as I know that I want to give you the option to be creative as well. Everyone has the self-sacrifice thing, and it makes it easier to protect. That does not necessarily mean that you cannot protect one you are not bound to. So right now, no one is bound to any soul caches. Everyone still has the ability to use the self-sacrifice power. If you bind yourself to an individual soul cache, that will give you a benefit to make the self-sacrifice less of a problem for you. Does anyone have any questions about either the room or the handout?
Can we bind ourselves to two soul caches?
No, you may not. You may only bind yourself to one.
Okay, and second is the angels one, angel ones actually don't have names. We don't see them.
I will fix that.
How about the corpses?
What information do you want about the corpses?
Are they treated as difficult terrain?
They are not.
Are they?
If you from the people that have interactions with these things before, and as you guys go and begin the fight, you will realize that touching one of the corpses immediately dissolves it into ash.
Okay.
So it sounds like everyone is ready, if that is the case. I think my understanding is that people are delaying for Gabriella to do Warmaster's Assault. If that is not the case, please let me know. So, Ophelia, Falrus, Lord Merrill, and Soroka, are any of you not delaying?
I can call her.
Gabrielle, you're first.
Okay, let's go full Nova then.
One second. This is a more like a nitpicky thing. The Reaper Angel, all of the angels on the map have a particular effect on them right now, where you get a penalty to attack rolls against them. I am marking that on my end as a bonus to defenses. If you have something that works with penalty, that works against penalty to attack rolls, please let me know. Otherwise, everyone can effectively ignore it. There's that.
Okay, sure. I will start out with instant planning, so everyone's getting +5. Then I'll pop my Vanguard weapon, and then I will Warmaster's Assault. I'll take the charge first. Charge to this Reaper, pull a 17 out of my dice to score what I certainly hope will be a hit. So this is with some silly bonus. That's a 41 to hit.
Oh. Yep, 41 hits all the things all the time.
Yep, so 26 damage. Now everyone else can charge or make a basic attack with +6 to attack and +10 to damage, and you'll all keep +6 to attack and +5 to damage until my next turn.
If you would, could you write that on the map for me, please?
Yeah.
Specifically the ones that they'll get past this round. So everyone go ahead and make your attacks and let me know what goes on.
I will charge the same Reaper. I will use my reach to be able to hit it, despite Gabriella being there.
Okay.
Oh wait, there should be 5 fire. I forgot the +5, so 43 damage. 43 damage. I incorrectly included something.
The Reaper that you struck against seems to be very resistant to Radiant.
Oh, well, at least he has now 10 less resistant.
Okay, so Falrus, go ahead, charge.
What are the bonuses? I believe it's... Are you sure it's +6 to attack and +5 to damage?
I'm stacking power bonuses at the moment for this attack, so it's, +6 to attack, +10 to damage.
Because actually only one says it's power bonus, the others just say bonus.
Yeah.
I think he's saying, if you get a chance, put power bonus in Warmaster's Assault.
Yep.
Just put it in the macro.
Okay, I will do that.
Can I charge to D-square?
You cannot. Yes. Are you asking, can you charge... Is this a standable square? Is that the question?
Yeah, pretty
yes,
much.
Yes, it is. The only square that is actually blocking terrain is the center square.
Okay, and let me check. Because I never actually used that. At the start of every encounter, combat... I have not yet acted, yes. So yeah, I have combat advantage against him. And it's a MBA. So that's about 7 and +12. That's 35 to AC, 36 damage.
Let's see. 36 damage, got it. Armada, I'm looking up this. I don't see your roll. I might be missing it though.
31 against AC from Armada.
Oh, is that with all the bonuses?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yes, that does miss.
Sorelka, Meryl?
Meryl, Sorelka?
Okay.
Take your turns? Or not
I'll
take your turns, but charge.
Yeah. I'll go ahead and charge the Reaper Angel there.
Okay.
And that's my Virtuous Strike right there.
Okay, so 25 radiant. It seems to not really do much of anything to this guy.
Okay.
He does take damage, he just doesn't take a lot.
Ready for me to go?
Yep, go ahead.
Alright, I'll charge to there. I'm attacking the Reaper Angel in the lower left corner.
Okay. The Sirocco charge, the where you charge and then have to clarify who you're attacking on the map.
35 AC.
Yep, 24 damage.
Yeah, and I'll knock him prone and mark him blue 3. If he is a shadow or undead creature, he can also take 6 radiant damage and explode until that.
He is not a shadow or undead creature.
Great. I am going to do a no action on top of that. Wolfsbound this, knock him double prone, 6 squares.
Okay.
Here, and attack the Sandflow Reaper.
It doesn't really matter, but he did not get double proned.
Okay.
You recognize that effect did not have any effect on him if it would have normally.
Oh, so he's immune to fear. Aha, okay.
Yes.
Oh, that's the wrong button. Shadowflow Reaper.
Thirty-three AC on the Reaper will not connect, unfortunately.
I'll mark him red 3 or blue 3.
Is that with the standing plus 5 or plus 6 right now?
It is. I rolled a 4.
Saddest day. Alright. Is that it for Gabriella's charge?
Yes, that is my turn done.
Ophelia, you're up.
I'll begin by drawing a Plague of Frogs 1 square above ground, so it only affects large creatures. It does not touch medium creatures. Over here.
Okay.
I will use Guidance of the Past on this. That looks like a hit to me. Let me drop the macro itself.
So, not dazed?
Then I will teleport in place address. Actually, no, I will teleport to... I'll come up with teleport a bit later. I'll drop an action point.
Okay.
Do you want to play the game?
Of course.
Gather up presence.
Of course you want. So I will try to then Kenya on the bottom guy who is currently vulnerable radiant.
I have a mark as such.
I will use guidance of the past again. Probably a hit. That is not a critical, unfortunately. But he can be slit 3 squares over here.
Did you include vulnerability on your end?
I did not.
Okay.
Because you said that he is resistant, so it's simpler on you if I don't do it.
Yeah, I agree. I was just double checking.
Yeah, he can take 52 radiant and go over here and be prone. For entering the zone, he'll take some damage.
He is gonna get bloodied during this.
Then from Bravura Peasants, I get to make a melee basic against him.
But before that happens, he's gonna have his bloody trigger. Bloodied. Where is his bloody trigger? Hang on. Is it not marked? Actually, never mind. I was incorrect. Carry on. Go on.
Okay, I will now try to MBA him. Spectre attack. Damage.
Okay.
Now, I want to teleport somewhere. I will use this as my minor action. I will teleport to... Oops, choices.
You teleport somewhere. Anything else
and,
to do?
Oh yeah, and he can get a red blob.
Anything else?
And that's it for my turn.
Faris, you're up.
Okay. I'm going to move over here. That's in 5, that's in 10, okay. First attack will be on the Reaper, second on the Angel. That's right, that's a plus 4 on this guy. No, that's plus 6 on this guy and plus 8 on this guy. And a total of plus 7 here and plus 7 here. So that's a critical miss on the Sandflow Reaper and 42 on the Angel.
The 42 and the Angel will definitely connect.
Let me see, can I actually reroll that? I cannot. I don't have anything to reroll that, but I will use Tower of Power Preservation to not recover that power. Anyway. 33 damage to this guy, and I'm going to slide him in this direction, I guess.
Okay, he goes there.
Okay, as a minor, let's see. Let's see, I'm just going to chuck a dagger of speed at him, why not? Again, at the Reaper Angel. That's at the side. And so that's 48 AC. Should hit for 40 damage. And yeah, I guess I'm done.
Meryl.
If no one has any objections, I'd like to delay to be the last person to go so I know who's still alive, so I know who to tank.
Okay, Soroka.
Sorry, I was muted. I will move to here. I will minor action to start the. Hopefully, something that will actually back the chain ward. Mara back up. I will. My standard to do a razor strike. First target is the Sandflow Reaper over here.
Okay.
And we are now only plus 5 to damage, is that correct?
Yes.
Wow, this is terrible. 32 AC?
32 AC does not connect, unfortunately.
For 8, I will mark him, blue 3. I will shift here. Attack. The second target, which will be this guy.
Okay.
41 AC.
Yep.
Great. 22 damage if he is an undead creature. I think he is, yes?
He is an undead creature. However, you do notice that he resists the radiant damage.
Okay, but he's slowed.
He is slowed.
Alright, and then shift to attack this Reaper Angel.
I would actually like to react to Soralka hitting that guy.
Okay, go ahead.
Before I shift or after?
Just giving MBAs to the two people next to him.
Oh, nice.
I think I hit harder than Soralka does. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure everybody here hits harder than I do.
Okay.
My MBA just knocked him prone.
Wow.
Double ones.
I'll try to reroll.
Use a one from your dice too.
I'll try to reroll that again. Okay, that finally looks like a hit.
So yes.
That should be 16 higher. 51 versus reflex on my end.
That hits, and the 30 reflex. The 30 reflex is not going to connect.
Oh, by the way, question. Did you have a short rest since after walking around, walking towards the city, since after walking through the plains of draining surges? Okay, then I have my encounter roll back, which is nice.
Does a 36 connect?
Yes, it does.
Okay, I will add a bit of damage onto that because I forgot to do this in the first place. Woo! 34 damage then.
Gabriel, if it's possible, can you push him up one or will that fuck over everyone?
He's gonna die, so.
Oh, okay.
So, he's gonna die, and when he does, he's going to explode. So you see his form kind of break apart.
Wait,
as the.
Gary, question. What? Could you say that it was me who finished him off to zero HP?
Yes, we could, if you're going to try to cheese that you would know that he has a death effect and slide him across the room.
No,
also no?
I plan to teleport here either way. I wanted to be adjacent to this guy so that I kill him.
Okay.
I mean, that was my intention regardless of the death first, because I wanted to be adjacent to my next.
Okay, so you're now the first target instead of the last.
Okay, that's fine today.
So, 27 will on Ophelia, 25 on Meryl, 29 on Armada, 28 on Soralka, and 35 on Gabriella.
Well, that hits.
So, 14 necrotic damage, and you fail a death saving throw. Mark with the little skull and crossbows that you failed a death save. So, the hourglass shatters, and the creature dies.
May I continue my standard action?
Yep.
Everybody good?
Yep.
So there, and the last attack is on the Reaper Angel. Let me think about this. I'm thinking I'll go here to get combat advantage.
Okay.
Oh yeah, attack bonus. So 49 and 43 versus AC.
Both of those will connect for a total of 43.
Right, and then oh yeah, it's an A.
Anything else?
I wish.
Armada, you're up. Yuho, you there?
Sorry, weird name. Okay. I will start by moving away from this guy.
Are you going to provoke?
Yes.
Alright, he'll take it. Soralka, he's violating Mark. Oh, crap. These guys are... The burst attack that just went out from other people, would a plus two to those rolls have made anyone who got missed hit?
Nope.
Cool. It should have done an extra 2 points of damage, so Gabrielle, if it matters, take an extra 2 points of damage. I did not realize that I am working at the wrong AL right now.
You not get prone, Sarah Luka, correct?
I will not get prone, yes. I just wanted to wait until Gary was ready.
Yeah, sorry. I was fixing the AL theft. So 50 AC definitely connects.
24 damage, I'll knock him prone.
He takes a swing. He is now bloodied. So this is going to be a minus 3, and since these are old macros, I can't really fix it.
That's actually minus 5, but okay.
Yeah, well, I just clicked the lower button, so. But I believe it misses, and Ryder, you're up. Well, continue, go your turn, I should say.
Yeah. Then I will... I will just charge this guy. I suppose that's a thing I can do. I will Iron Dragon charge him. And I just remember the bonuses the other warlord gives me.
And my roll 20 just randomly rushed.
For 9 AC. Yeah. Carry on.
Meryl.
Okay. I want to start off with Taste of Life. If that hits, I want a Blood Drinker.
It does.
Okay, 1 second. Yeah,
he seems to be quite resistant to necrotic as well. I think I improperly marked him as bloodied from Soroka's attack, or from whoever just hit him, but he's now bloodied.
Oh, okay.
Can we tell how resistant he is?
Very. That did almost no damage to him.
God damn it. Okay.
Yeah, if you do a monster knowledge check, you can find it.
Yes.
Yeah, my monster knowledge checks are pretty bad. Okay. I am then... I'm gonna go ahead and... Shit, that kind of ruined my plans. I'm gonna just go ahead and mark him, I guess.
Are you gonna override Throck's mark?
Actually, you know what? Change that. I am going to actually go ahead and action point.
Okay, toss an action point out there for me.
I am then going to Majestic Halo.
Oh, by the way, do you want to play the game?
No, I just do radiant damage anyway. Oh wait, what's the thing it can do? It can give me a move, right?
Move action or a basic attack.
I'll do the move action, and I can do it after my attack, right?
You have to hit, yes.
If you hit, but yes.
Yeah, I'll take the gamble.
Go ahead and swing. Uh, 34 AC will connect.
Okay. And then I will take my move, and he can take his attack against me.
He swings at a minus 5, so 35 AC.
That will hit exactly.
33 points of scythe flavored damage.
Would you like a powerful warning?
Yeah, actually, I would.
Well, in that case, here you go. And you can smack back as well.
Oh, sweet.
Don't forget, you still have +5.
So 47, and it does damage to him.
Okay. Oh yeah, I forgot I was missed by, or I was hit by one, but still a powerful warning would make it miss.
Yep, so you miss.
Okay. And then I still have a move and a minor. So I'm going to advance next to the Sand Float Reaper.
Okay.
And I'm going to Divine Challenge him.
So overriding Mark over there instead.
Yep.
Cool.
And that is the end of my turn.
Reaper Angel, the one that is down here who is prone. He's going to stand up. And then I believe, let me look at distance real quick. I can't do that. So, he is going to, he's going to fly and charge at Gabriella probably. Actually, yeah, he's going to fly charge at Gabriella. He's going to end there. So this is going to be with a plus one to hit.
That will hit pretty easily.
So 20 points of damage. He's then going to action point. And is going to swing at Gabriella and fly over towards the other soul cache. He's going to use on death swings for a swing at Gabriella without the plus one, natural one, and then we'll fly to here. All right, the Reaper Angel begins in the zone, takes some damage.
Yeah, 1 second.
Damn.
You guys are going to become aware of a trait that the Reaper Angel has. You see, as it kind of comes up, its body starts to break apart. You see this weird sort of black sand leak from the angel and slide along the ground towards that central soul cache. As he takes a little bit more damage.
Can you give us is that like some element of it is returning to that cache?
Yeah, some element of the life force that's in the angel now that has been damaged is going back to that central soul cache. It is going to use on death swings to strike at both Soroka and Ophelia.
This makes a melee basic. What does it make two basics in the process?
If you continue reading, you'll get the answer to your question. So first one at Soroka.
Ah.
Is going to miss. Second one at Ophelia is likely also going to miss. So he's going to fly to here, I think. One further. He's going to get to there. And he is going to minor action mark the person that marked him. So he should have done that beforehand, but it doesn't really matter that much. So Soroka, I would have been at 31, but I still miss you. You can do whatever notation you want, but I will probably remember which one has you marked. Oh, that's right, it's marked by that guy. So let's make their mark color orange, and let's do orange one. Reaper Angel that's down here.
I was so far ahead of you.
Nice. Reaper Angel that's down here is going to minor action mark on Faros. So orange 2 on you, Faros. Actually, no, this guy has an action point. The other one's going to action point first. So he is going to spend his action point, and he is going to use on-death swings again and swing through first attack at Mariel, second attack at Armada. Going to get to here. So 36 on Meryl and 24 on Armada.
Yep.
So So 26 damage if I hit you. He's going to end there. And then the other guy's going to start his turn. Mark Spalrus. Then he's going to use On Death's Wings to fly up and swing at you and then fly away.
Okay, that's a miss.
He goes to here, swings, so it's 34 AC as a total, by the way.
No, 34, that won't hit, but I think I will just use Anticipate Attack and make it a miss.
Okay, so he's gonna fly over here and then end. Sandflow Reaper is going to mark the person who has him marked. That is the wrong ability. I apologize. He is not the one that has the mark. Well, you guys now know that that's the ability that he has. So he is going to swing at the person that has him marked, I believe. Yep, that is the best way to go about it. 32 AC on Lord Merrill.
Mess.
He is then going to attempt to shift back one to here. Does anything bad happen to him?
Nope. What's his markler?
He actually doesn't. He doesn't mark you. I confuse the buttons. If nothing happens when he shifts back, he is going to action point and turn his sand at you, and then attempt to strike you with the inverted hourglass. 34 versus will on Meryl.
Yep, that'll hit.
19 radiant and slows save ends. Let me know if you fail the saving throw. This Sandflow Reaper is going to fly. Actually, he's not really been engaged yet. So he's just going to take an action to destroy one of the charges on the Soul Cache. Meryl is slowed, I believe. Yes. We will come up to here and then try to take advantage of the slow with the passage of time. So 38 versus Meryl.
Yep, that'll hit.
Yeah. He isn't in cold burst 5 of Meryl.
One closer.
He should be a bit closer.
Okay. There. I'll put him there. So
that'll hit.
And there's a T in the end of next, but I'm bad at life. At the end of the round, you can see the sand continue to flow into that central soul cache, and you see some movement around in the darkness that's flowing over top of the multicolored orb. Gabriella, you're up.
Okay. All these guys having reach 2 is really inconvenient. I guess I'm going to delay till after Ophelia. Oh yeah, it's just I wanted the death from two sides, but they're all standing one square away from everyone, so I can't enable anybody.
I'm just making sure you guys that you knew that because it would have been found out by someone else. So you delay until after Ophelia?
Yeah, so all the bonuses will go away.
Okay, Ophelia, you're up.
I will teleport 9 with an encounter to teleport over here. From this distance, how hard would it be to try to bond with this one?
You get a minus 1 to your check for each square away. So you're 10 squares away, you get a minus 10.
So yeah, that's basically impossible. That would be extremely difficult. Okay, let me check back. I will spend the Zalmo and invite to the right just in case, because I don't have any other minor actions I can use from this distance. And I'll try to charge the angel.
Okay.
Let me see what clay is. It's too far to protect the cache. Was there a way for me to get closer to it? No, there's no closer protection. Oh, okay. Uh, is vulnerable, so it probably matters.
He is vulnerable. He is also resistant.
And he'll get a red buff.
Anything else?
No, I end my turn. Oh, actually, no, there is something else. Let me find the button. He'll take 7 more damage.
Okay. He's granted combat edge because something.
Because I have Inkstalker.
Okay. Gabriella, you're up.
Okay. I will move over to here. Hunter's Gaze, this Reaper Angel, and then Death from Two Sides it. So, Ophelia can make an auto crit if I can land a hit anyway. 35?
35 hits, and we'll get the words to describe your kill.
Oh, well, that was a bit of a... Oh, well. Gabriella will... yes, crit the... while it's busy with Ophelia, Gabriella runs up behind it and impales it with the surprisingly pointy tip of her parasol. And that is all of my...
You didn't kill or bloody an enemy, Ophelia.
Oh, damn, I pressed the wrong button. Let me find the correct button.
So it's gonna explode first.
Yeah, I think this one... An enemy adjacent to me drops to him. I knew I had something that works like that.
Cool. So, after you teleport, it's gonna explode?
Well, I'm still at plus 5.
You are indeed. So, Meryl, you're first with 26, then Armada at 38, Gabriella at 39, and Ophelia at 30, and Faurus at 28, which will be a total of 30 because of the granting combat advantage. So if you get hit, 29 points of necrotic damage, and you fail a death saving throw.
Cool. I'd like to humbly request that nobody kill any angels, unless I'm not within 5 squares of them.
The Reapers do it too.
Yeah, all of them, yeah. Oh, right, they aren't angels. Yeah. Anyway, that's my turn done.
Faurus, you're up.
Okay, let's see. Apart from... So, the mark I have means that I grant combat advantage, and I'm marked, so -2 to attack, probably.
-2 to attacks, and possibly something else.
And possibly something else. Sucks. Let's see. And Ophelia went over to that guy, so I don't get combat advantage.
Great. You can flank.
Yeah, but I wanted to be, you know, in the adjacent to bow, but it doesn't matter. I just wait on this. No, I can't. Everything is gone to shit.
I mean, okay. If you told me, I could just teleport something like here.
I don't think you can stay there.
I think that's a legal square to be in.
Just, it is a legal square, but also no. Just take your turn, Faurus.
Oh, yep. I will move over there. Let's see. I will just go ahead and low slash the guy. Yeah, that's marking me, of course. I believe all the bonuses are gone by now. So that's a 39 on reflex.
Definitely connects.
I'm going to add to it. Actually, he takes 40 damage because I'm flanking. I'm going to... let's see. I can't really slide him in any way that's useful. So that sucks. He's slowed. And he is dazed now.
He is slowed, he is dazed, and he's bloodied.
And he's bloodied. Oh, okay. Then, let's see. That doesn't really help me. I just go ahead and... I can't... Can I stay in this square?
You cannot stand on top of the orb. Well, actually, you can stand on top of the orb, but you're going to need to make some sort of check, and You can tell that having prolonged direct contact with these orbs is going to have negative things happen.
Okay, then I'm just going to go ahead and let's go ahead and use blood buff on the. Actually, should not do that. No, I have to attack this guy. Sorry. I will use blood buff on the Reaper Angel next to me. No, I can't do that. Sorry. I just use that flourish on him because I'm taking too long. That's 35 for 25 damage, and I'm down and safe against the pink.
Okay. Soroka, you're up.
Alright, I will move. Do Tempest Dance Strike. First target is the Reaper Angel. Below me.
Okay, go ahead.
I think actually I'm going to change that up. I'm going to do Serpent. So anyway, Reaper Angel below me. First, they still have their defensive bonus.
Yes, but don't worry about it. I'm just doing it on my own.
But it was, you said it was in the first round. I'm like, okay. 37 AC.
This is the thing, by the way. That'll hit.
Okay, 21 damage. Where's second target will be the Sandflow Reaper right here.
Okay. That is 37. That one, yeah. So it's also a 37 for 21 again.
Yeah. Roll my four dice, a little different.
Okay.
We'll shift up to there. Third target is the next Sandflow Reaper.
Okay. Are you overriding mark or no?
Meryl, do you care if I override your mark?
You can go ahead, but I'm going to remark them all on my turn because I'm going to pop a defensive.
Then I will override, or, I mean, you know, she goes before it does, so don't override it, I guess. Leave it there.
Okay.
Go after me.
Oh, is there a way you could end any square other than that one? Just because
I am not, I'm going to be so far away from this square, you will not even see me probably on your view of the map.
Oh, cool.
34 AC.
Uh-huh.
Damage. Here, and I will attack this last Reaper Angel. Oh, it is granting CA.
It is dazed.
37 AC? Boy, that was consistent, wasn't it?
21 damage is the thing that you do.
Weren't three of them 37 AC, too?
Yeah.
Yes, that was bizarre.
Yeah, that one weird one for 34 and 22, which is just strange, but, you know.
When they die and they do their thing, is that a reaction that would not happen while it's dazed?
It is a no action that triggers at death.
Oh, all right. All right, I'm going to go ahead and action point.
And do you want to play the game?
Tell me what the game is.
Bravura presence.
Yeah, does that thing trigger off their death or them dropping to zero hit points?
They are equivalent in this area. You do not get the feeling that you have the ability to prevent them from actually dying if they are dropped to zero. As when they're bloodied, part of their essence leaks out and goes to the orb anyways, so you can tell that if you knock them unconscious instead of killing them, it will basically delay the effect until their turn starts, and then the sand flowing out of them will kill them. So it's not useless, it just will delay the effect rather than remove it.
All right. Okay, so if the action point hits, I can make a or take a move. Yeah, I'll do that for sure. So do I do that first? No.
That happens afterwards. So it's whether you hit or miss with this attack.
Okay. Well, this is going to be a form of blows.
So you can hit and miss.
Yeah, I'll do it all. I will start with the Reaper Angel. Actually, I'm going to start with the this Reaper Angel down here.
Okay.
Crit. That'll do 26 damage and 17 radiant damage.
It does 26 damage.
Okay, and we'll shift. Second attack is against the Sandflow Reaper up here. Get that?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yep. 39 AC for 21 damage.
Yep.
Next attack will be against this guy.
Okay.
Five AC for, you guessed it.
He takes 21 damage. Anything else?
Yes, well then I will shift four more. Four. I will minor action to link myself to this cash pink one.
Okay.
Is that a skill check thing? I can't remember.
You do have to justify some form of skill.
Yeah, then yes. I would like to use the, my knowledge of nature, connection to the primal source, to of my warden abilities to link myself to the cache.
Okay.
What did you take from the presence?
I will take a move action.
Mm-hmm. So you are now connected to the pink source.
So that was a move action from
anything else from you, Soraka?
Yeah, I'm gonna move there and I'll be done.
Armada, you're up.
Inspiring word on Gabriella, move. Charge the Reaper Angel down below and invite Gabriella to charge with me. Hoping she goes way to the left so that people can nuke the others.
Sure, I can do that. So, like there?
Yep.
Okay.
That's the inspiring and... Thirty-one AC, I believe, misses, if I remember correctly.
31 misses, yes, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm. Main point is to get Gabriella out of there. I have Iron Dragon Charge up.
He's using so... Iron Dragon Charge, so Gabriella has to use an immediate reaction to charge with you.
Yeah.
So just be aware that Gabriella, you've used your immediate now.
Okay, that's fine. I had no meaningful immediates left.
Okay, just letting you know.
And pass turn.
The 32 versus reflex will connect for 26, and it does look like it's damage flavor damage.
Yes, just damage.
The Reaper Angel is no longer having extra defenses and is now bloodied. Meryl.
Okay. I'm going to use my cloak power to become insubstantial. I am then going to run. And then I am going to call a challenge. And then I'm going to save.
So call a challenge, everybody's marker purple?
Yep. And I fail my save.
Insubstantial, nothing else I need to do. Okay, cool. Reaper Angel.
Gary, she failed a save. You told to tell you when she fails a save.
I did in point of fact. So, let me make sure that I'm not crazy. It's the slow effect, right? Yes, this one. You take 23 points of necrotic damage.
23 points of necrotic?
Yes. And I think the point that the reason she's overriding is so that she can take advantage of the insubstantial and bonuses to defenses.
Oh, it's
exactly.
Base. Perfect.
And, okay, so 23 necrotic, subtract 12, becomes 11, cut in half, becomes 5.
Accurate. Actually, yeah, accurate. Stupid different rules with different types of half damage. Alright, this guy starts his turn, he takes 20 points of damage. And then he is now bloodied, so he is going to, on death's wings, the first target, well, he did not get a chance in minor action to mark somebody, so he's going to mark Soroka. You're not granted combat advantage save ends. He is then going to use on death's wings. The first target is going to be Soroka, the second target is going to be Gabriella. Are you bloodied? I assume not.
Oh, right, no, I forgot to take the bloodied thing off when I healed.
Good. Making sure you didn't qualify as bloody or count as bloody for other stuff. So, yeah, that's the only thing. So he's gonna earn death swings on Gabriella and Armada, or sorry, not Gabriella, on Soroka and Armada. So 41 on Soroka and 30 on Armada.
Yeah, miss.
He would shift to here and do this. Then he's gonna go one. Yeah, let's do the thing. He's gonna go to there. Reaper Angel, who is dazed and bloodied, so he's gonna take ongoing damage. Any way to get out of the daze? Oh, Soroka, you got hit by that guy doing combat advantage. It does an extra 11 points of damage, and you take a negative 2 penalty to saving throws for the end of the Reaper's turn. The other guy is going to... Faris, you've successfully saved, correct?
Yes. Yeah.
Cool. So he is going to mark Ophelia.
Okay, that's his only action.
No, he's going to action point.
Okay.
So, he is going to action point, and then he is going to, first swing at Falrus, and then swing at Ophelia.
Okay.
And he's gonna violate mark?
Yeah, he's gonna violate mark.
And he'll have a -3 to these attacks.
Cool. Orange one on the Reaper that marked you, yes. So, Faris with a -1 on this attack. So, it does 33 points of damage. You take a -2 penalty to saving throws.
I'm going to make him roll that, yep. Second chance.
Okay. So, 37 versus your AC.
And the -5 says 32.
Oh, 30. Yes, 32 then. Where's your AC?
32. Yeah, that will miss because of the devout expertise.
Nice.
And I can slack lodge.
Okay.
I will do that against him.
Okay. I'm gonna assume you have some way not to provoke.
It's many.
Okay.
Thirty-five
AC hits.
32 damage.
So he's gonna move to here and swing at Ophelia.
Moving before swing at me is just cheating. Yeah, that's a hit.
So a total of -2, so it'll be that, and then an extra 5 points of damage. And he's gonna finish moving to there. Sandfill Reaper. He's got some stuff going on. Meryl, you are still slowed, correct?
Yep, that is correct.
So he will actually use the thing that he attempted to use last time. It's going to be 26 versus 42, which I believe is going to miss you.
Yes, it will, by 1 point. Woo-hoo. Oh shit, I'm granted combat advantage. Did you include that?
I did not.
So that will hit me by 1 point.
So 16 necrotic and radiant, and the same effect as last time. He is then going to... Well, he probably should have done this in the other order, but whatever. He will ranged bolt on to Falrus. 28 versus Will and Falrus.
That hits right on.
Does he include the -3 for being marked?
He does not, and you can punish him if you would like, but...
Then that's a miss.
So, 25 versus Will. It does not seem to do any damage to him. He does not have an action point remaining, so that's it for him. Does he want to stay over here in all this cluster? Probably not. So he will fly... Oh, he's only got 2 squares of flight, so he'll stay in the cluster. Move over here. This guy is also slow. It has shenanigans and stuff going on. He's going to shift back one. Does that provoke anything from Meryl?
Nope.
He's going to violate mark and bolt on Falrus. That's going to miss, and then he's going to minor action. Oh no, he's already used it, so that is it for him, it looks like.
If you guys want to... Oh, I was going to say, if you guys want to blow up the Reaper Angel... Oh wait, never mind, there's two of them. Go ahead.
I will sustain the zone, moving it 1 square to the right. I will teleport over here because excuse this Reaper. Actually, does anyone want me anywhere else? I'd probably be here, actually. Okay. That suits me.
I'd prefer the first spot.
This one? Okay. That
yeah.
Works for me. I will impiate this guy.
I prefer you attack the other bloody Reaper engine.
And this one seems to be closer to death, and I kinda want to remove an enemy from the map. And I'm also marked by. And I don't want to violate their mark while I don't even know what violation does.
Carry on with your turn.
Go ahead.
So, that's presumably a hit.
It is.
What was the end condition of the mark?
It's save ends.
Well, that hit lets me save, and I'm not no longer marked.
Okay.
But I don't have anything else to do on my turn, so I end my turn.
Gabriela.
Okay, I'm gonna hit that Reaper Angel next to Ophelia, so I guess if Sorelka and Armada want to leave the burst, I'll delay until after them. Are you guys going to leave the burst?
I am.
Okay, I will delay then.
To repeat something I said earlier, however, if you do want to deal non-lethal to one of these guys and knock them out instead of killing them and you reduce them to zero, it will delay the explosion until they start up their turn.
Oh yeah, good point. So I don't have to delay. That's convenient. So I'll start off by throwing a heal over to Meryl.
Oh, thank you.
Then I'll walk... what is it? 1, 2... Over to here. And then, Ophelia, you can attack that Reaper.
Okay. No bonuses?
No bonuses.
Okay. By the way, he should be vulnerable by now because of my previous attack.
Mm-hmm. Okay. He is, but he's got a hit point left, so I don't really want to mark it. So, okay. He dies.
Well, and that's non-lethal. But I'll still use that teleport still over here. Adjacent to market.
Okay, and that's my turn done.
Forus.
Okay, let me see. I don't really want to be close. I'll just use Spinning Blade Leap to shift 7 over to here and attack the Sandflow Reaper over there.
Okay.
Because he seems to be all alone. For 44 versus AC.
44 versus AC will definitely connect.
Okay, 39 damage. That's that. I will try and get myself connected to this spirit, this kasha or whatever. Let's see. I think I will just while shifting, I will just shift through it and jump across it and.
So when you touch against it, you feel the immediate contact of the soul inside, and as you sort of move along through it, you can feel the soul inside is actually quite powerful, and your touch against the orb links you to it without a check.
Okay, that's cool. Let's see. That's a minor. That's actually. I'm going to use this because why not? If he ends his turn, he will take 5 gold damage, and I will shift over here.
Okay.
And the angel that is going to die is no longer a distance load, but anyway, that's all.
Soroka, at the start of your turn, you feel some weird feedback coming from the soul cache that you're connected to. Right. It's dreams that are like dreams or images from the thing that are very dark and very elemental and primordial in nature. You get the image of a volcano erupting, of fires engulfing everything, and this idea of incredible destruction through fire.
This is a horrible way to learn that Hearth died.
Okay, keep going, Soraka.
Alright, I will Yeah, this is a rough one. Let's see. I will delay.
Armada, you're up.
Okay. So, Sarelka, do you want to heal?
It's not of paramount importance, but if you've got nothing better to do, sure.
I got nothing better to do. And then I'll move charge the guy way up there. And if Ophelia or Meryl wants... Actually, do I trigger the charge in correct place? Yeah. So if either of them has the ability to charge with me, they can do
such. So. No, I think you make the charge attack first. I'll wait there until you make...
I'm accurate at 31 AC for a miss.
Yes.
I don't actually wrong. It should be plus one to attack, but advantage. No damage bonus. That's probably a hit.
That is definitely a hit, yes.
What doesn't happen when I delay?
When you delay, the end of your turn does not occur, so you don't
right,
make saves.
I'm,
the end of your turn.
I'm taking the save from the heal that Armada did.
Gotcha. Sorry, I thought you
just
delay.
No sweat. I just wanted to make sure the mark. I heard you say Ophelia was save ends. Is that correct?
Yes, it is.
Also, the Sandflow Reaper can away Ophelia. Probably.
Why?
Maybe.
Yeah, he can.
Why is? Oh, the one that's down here can away him. Yes.
Because
he'll take it with the penalty, so it'd be minus 3 to this. Mm-hmm. He misses.
That's a miss.
So I end my turn.
Can you throw like hit
you're up.
Higher to hit?
Alrighty. I'm gonna move. First target will be the Sandflow Shadow Reaper. Do you care if I override your mark smell?
As long as it's not something close to death, go right on ahead.
Okay. So just don't override this guy in the top corner?
Yeah, because I think I got something for him.
So first target is Sandflow Reaper over here.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be marking the. I'll keep the Reaper Angel next to, well, next to Meryl marked, and I'll mark this guy, and the other guy won't. Okay.
Thirty-one AC will miss.
Second target is the other one.
Okay.
Thirty-two AC.
Double hit.
Oh, good. 16 damage.
He's reslowed. Anything else?
Yeah, last hit is on, or last attack is on this Reaper Angel here.
Okay. Thirty-seven AC for 16 will hit.
Yeah. Great.
Anything else?
Yeah, yeah. Does anyone need a heal, Ophelia? Are you okay?
I'm fine.
Okay. I will go ahead and
sorry.
No, that's fine. It's fine.
Okay. I'm going to, while people are still marked from my Call of Challenge, specifically that guy up there, I'm going to Symbol of the Champions code him.
Okay.
I am then going to... I'm going to go ahead and mark the Reaper Angel next to me with Divine Challenge.
Okay.
And then I am... going to go ahead and Aura of Grandeur.
Okay.
And that will be my turn. And so... Oh, one sec, then let me remove a couple of things and do my Aura and I'll make a save.
So this Reaper Angel will begin his turn. He does not have anyone marked anymore, so he will choose to mark Lord Meryl. He's then going to...
Oh, and I failed my save, if that matters.
Yes, it does, so take some necrotic damage. He's going to swing at you, Meryl, as he goes to fly over towards Soroka as well.
Is it 23 necrotic like last time, or...?
It's a different number. I'll do the roll in a minute. He's going to 28 AC on you, which I believe misses.
Yep.
He's going to fly to here and swing at Soroka.
Is he not provoking somehow?
This.
Oh, he's doing that again. Okay. Thought it was something else.
On death swings. So he's doing the bloody thing. Cause basically, you're forcing him to make you one of the targets.
Yeah.
So 31 against you, Soroka.
Misses.
And then he is going to fly... to here, I think? Yeah, I'll go to here. He's going to take 20 points of damage at the start of his turn. And that is it for him. Other Reaper Angel, let me do the... Meryl, 19 points of necrotic damage from the one thing, from the failed saving throw.
Okay, I'm still insubstantial until the end of my turn, so would that still be in effect for that?
So all of these triggers are at the end of your turn, so you can choose whatever order you want if you would like to take less damage.
Oh yeah, I'll take less damage. So I'll take 5 necrotic from that.
Yeah, I'm not trying to be obtuse, I'm trying to give the explanation of the rule rather than just giving you an answer.
Okay.
The one will begin his turn and explode. I only have one target in range, and luckily I didn't crit anyone, so 26 versus Meryl.
We'll fail.
Excellent. So he dies. The Reaper up top. What is he gonna do? He can only attack Lord Meryl.
Yep.
Meryl is still slowed, so he is going to use this. Is he five? Is he within five? That's the real question. I believe he is. Yes, he is. So 23 versus fort, and I assume that misses. Meryl?
Yep.
Does he provoke? That is the real question. Oh, he's going to take damage. Then the question comes, does he provoke? I don't think he has a way to avoid it. So he's going to shift one square up to here. Actually, can we do it this way instead? Yes, he'll shift one square up to here. And then he's going to be above Armada, so he is still going to provoke, but he's going to provoke less attacks.
Do they hover?
Yeah, they can fly. So the Reaper flies up, although he's going to provoke almost the same number of attacks, because he's going to make a ranged attack, and Soroka, Armada, and Falrus are all going to be able to take the swing.
If I hit him, you're going to get to explain all kinds of rules to me, because I'm throwing him and make him fall. Shall we roll?
Yeah, yep. Soroka, Armada, and Falrus, go ahead and roll. He has a situational bonus here, but you guys can still ruin his turn.
This is an opportunity attack, correct?
It is indeed. He's making a range attack.
I wait after Sadelka because he might, not be prone and give me combat advantage.
Okay.
Granting CA. Okay, he's not.
He's not granting CA for any reason.
40 AC, 17 damage. I'll knock him prone and make him fall.
So he's now prone in that square?
Oh, that you don't have to explain anything to me. He's prone, so that he can be in the square as Armada.
Or you could technically slide him next to Ophelia.
Well, I can't prone him and slide him. I have to be one or the other.
That's true.
Yeah, but so, if you slide him, I would be able to also make an opportunity attack.
It's done. Just use your fingers to type if you have tactical decisions to make. Please. Because this takes too long for everyone to talk out their tactical choices. The 33 hits and does 12 points of damage, the 35 hits and does 39 points of damage.
And I will do one more because I have opportunistic weapon.
Okay, he's gonna... neither the 35 nor the 33 is gonna hit because I'm bad at remembering my own situational bonuses. Let's see, 30... Yes, the 35 and 33 will both miss. Unless you guys did not include combat advantage.
I did.
Okay, so they do both miss.
That
34 also misses. So he's going to take a negative 2 to this attack because he's now prone. And that is the wrong button to be this. So 18 on the die would have been 38 minus 2 is 36 versus Will on Meryl.
Yep, that'll hit. So I'll take 18 radiant and slowed.
Yep.
And I'm actually going to immediate reaction and greater storm shield him for 10.
Okay. And he will end his turn. The other Sandfall Reaper, who is not all the shenanigans, is marked by Soroka. So he is going to invert Hourglass on Soroka. Wow, natural one. Utter failure. Let's see. He's going to go fly and see if he can play with Gabriella. We gotta move to there. Ophelia, you're up.
I'll sustain the zone with points to the right. I will whack the prone Reaper. He is vulnerable, which is nice. Is that a hit?
Pretty sure it is. Let me double check. It is indeed.
My move action, I will assume that the Reaper will die, and I will teleport outside of his death burst.
Death burst. If you kill him before my turn comes up, he can't death burst.
That's actually true, but Okay, we'll teleport to here and that, for leader's sake.
Anything else?
That's... No, end of that.
Gabriella, you're up.
Yeah, do I need to delay? I'm not going to be doing anything in that area.
No.
Yeah, I will just punch a guy.
Thirty-four is gonna hit.
Okay. I will brain up hammers and punch again. Okay, so that's another 30 damage. And I'll push sorry, what?
Go ahead, sorry.
Okay. I'll push one up that way.
Okay.
And then move away. I have heaps of space to move in. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I'll move over to there. And that's my turn.
Varus, you're up.
Okay. So, let's see. I'm not sure that Meryl's pink is going to go off, so I'm going to go and use Puff of the Blade. And you do non-lethal.
Please don't do non-lethal. If my thing is going to go off, then, or if my thing is going to work, then non-lethal will completely circumvent it and it'll just blow up in everyone's face.
I'm going to do non-lethal because Sarelka needs a second target and unconscious target is still a target.
No, that's not, it's not that important.
I'm going to do non-lethal, doesn't matter. First target is Reaper, the second target is Angel.
Okay.
And actually before that I would use Perfect Feint as well to get CA on both of them.
Okay.
So that's CA on this guy, CA on this guy. CA on this guy, CA on this guy. 31 versus this guy as well, and crit on this guy.
31 versus Will is not going. Well, is going to connect against that guy, so he is non-lethally dropped to zero, and then the crit for 70 it looks like.
Yep.
The angel's in a world of hurt.
So I will slide this guy over to there, goes a bit away, and this guy can stay where he is. I'm going to shift 2, 3, and this time the first target is the angel.
Okay.
Let's see how well that goes. That's 39 and a crit, but 39 only matters. For 21 damage.
That's gonna get the words, describe your kill as he explodes.
I non-lethally...
Are you non-lethaling this guy as well?
Yep, that's I... Yep. Both
okay.
Of them. Yep, I just... punch him in the helm, I believe, and he knocks down. And I have 3, that's 5 left to go, then I can go over to here. And let's see. Yep, I'm going to use the item, this thing, and get us back, and that's all for me.
Armada, you're up.
Sorry, like, do you want to go first?
No, it doesn't matter now.
Okay. I'll move and direct the strike on Polaris to take an RBA on the guy.
Okay, do you give any bonuses?
No.
Sucks.
Unless you're MBA. Unless you're MBA. which would be a fate.
Yep. Let's see. 37 versus AC?
37 versus AC is going to connect, as 37 is not the magic number, but it seems to be what everyone rolls.
Yep.
He's not bloody.
Okay.
That went well. So I will minor action. Well, there is a soul cache kind of far away, but I don't really want to bind myself. Okay, pass turn.
Soraka, you're up.
Alright, I'm gonna move to there. I'm gonna, can I, is there an, so we can draw power from the souls that we've interacted with?
Mm-hmm.
Does that take an action to do?
I think the handout says something on it, but I can't remember.
Bit of luck.
Yes, you draw souls as a miner. Draw power from the soul as a miner.
I will, I'm gonna do that and see what happens, see if it inflames my spike chain or something with this fiery being.
So, do you touch the orb, or do you try to draw from it without touching it?
I try, well, am I adjacent to it in this square, or do I need
you're
to
not, you need to be one square over.
See if I could get there.
If you were here, you could go here.
I think I was here, actually.
Yeah, I think it was equidistant, so.
Yeah, same. It works.
So you touch it, and you see your chains light on fire. Until the end of your next turn, you deal fire damage instead of whatever you would normally deal, and you get a plus 5 bonus to damage rolls.
All right, great. And then I'm just going to footwork lure the Sandflow Reaper.
Okay.
So 41 AC. Added the 5 in, so 21 fire damage.
Magic number.
Wow.
Do you want to prone him?
That's bizarre. Yeah, I do. I want to prone him, and I'll shift there.
Lord Merrill, you're up.
Okay. I'm going to advance next to the Reaper that's still, still alive.
I know he doesn't take the damage carry, but I think he's slowed as well.
I am then going to go ahead and Hungry Swarm on him.
Aren't you slowed?
You are slowed, unless...
God damn it, yes I am. Shit, and I have no way to get around that, do I? Well, sure. Okay. Oh, say again? Oh, no, I got something. At least I can try to keep someone from eating an attack. I'm gonna dagger throw at the Shadow Flow Reaper. Or at the Sandflow Reaper. The one that's,
this one?
The one that's, yeah, knocked out.
Okay, so minus 2 plus 5, your total plus 3. So 32 AC, as has been established, is exactly what you need to hit. So he explodes, and he's only allowed to target you, so. 38 versus Will.
That will hit.
So 20 necrotic and fail the death save.
Well, he can, if I recall, I think he can only make attacks that target me. Or if he enemy can't make an attack that includes any creature other than me as a target, so I don't think he'd be able to make that attack, period.
True, because Armada is still in range. Correct. I kept thinking that Armada was going to move out of range, but he didn't.
I did too, I just forgot.
Okay, then I am going to advance and end my turn.
Save, please. 24 necrotic.
Okay, I'll take 12.
This one begins its turn and explodes. So, 30 versus Armada and 30 versus Meryl.
Miss.
The Reaper's gonna get to take an action, and then he's going to just die, because, well... this is his last action he's gonna be able to take in this for a little bit. So he stands up. He has a single target has the slow, so... he's going to range shot at Armada. Or no, he's marked. Sorry, he's marked. He's going to range shot at Soroka. He does provoke an attack of opportunity, however, because he is ranged attacking. Because he has no way to not provoke from this. So 31 AC does not connect. So 34 versus Will on you, Soroka.
Yeah, that hits easily.
So you're going to be slowed, and then he's going to do his close burst, which can only target, I think, Can't target Meryl, I can only target Soroka. So, Soroka, you're the only target. 25 versus Fortitude, which I think is going to miss because you're a fighter. And then he's going to end his turn, and it's pretty reasonable that everyone's going to just take their turn and beat the hell out of him.
Get far, far away from him.
Yeah, I feel like it is reasonable that you can kill him in such a way that I do not have to worry about the explosion. So, as the Reaper dies, you see the sands gathering around the edge of the large soul cache is starting to congeal. You can, as the kind of deathly... On your turn, you mean?
Right in that round where everybody was beating on that guy.
Yes, so I'm going to have that as part of the description coming up.
Okay.
So at the end of this round that is going to happen where the death, where he took his last turn, that's what's occurring now. So at the end of the round that he is still alive and you guys are going to kill him on the next turn, you can see that sand, that black stuff is gathering around. And as the deathly quiet of the lack of combat falls over the room, you can hear this sound, like the tinkling of something, as if something very, very small is beginning to crack. And you can see little imperfections starting to open on the orb in the very center. And you can hear, like, far off in the distance, like a roaring wind or maybe the call of voices that is being drowned out by some great sound. So, you guys all have a round where you could take actions. I'm going to go ahead and assume that you guys can kill the Reaper and that sort of stuff. I'm going to keep you all in initiative order for the moment. However, as we kind of go through this, I want to go through and see what you're doing. You can choose to, on your turn, you can choose to bind yourself to one of the soul caches. If you do bind yourself to a soul cache, you need to either end this sort of interim adjacent to one of the soul caches, or you need to make a check that would allow you to start the next kind of portion of this elsewhere. So, Ophelia, what are you doing in this sort of lull?
What actions can we take other than binding the soul cache? I'm not sure I entirely understand how actions work here.
You've got a couple of minutes, so it's things... You don't have enough time for a short rest, but you can reasonably kind of go around and do stuff if you would like.
And do effects that last until end of encounter persist?
There's a more complicated answer to that, which will happen in a second. For the moment, well, yes, they persist.
I mean, as part of my actions, I'd probably want to get this thing somewhere here.
Okay.
And
you are aware that if you do that, it is going to damage the cache.
It can be above the cache without touching. No?
Okay. If you'd like to be above the cache without touching, you can. So it's going to be two squares up.
And I'd probably like to try to bind to this one.
Okay. If you're going to touch it and end this sort of interim there, then you do not need to make a check.
Thank you.
Gabriella.
Yeah, I'm measuring out distances. Yeah, I'll just double move over to here and grab this cache.
Okay. Forrest.
Considering I'm already bound to one, can I, preparing for what's going to come, try to draw power from my cache? That's a check of some sort.
If you're touching it, so basically if you're going to end the interim next to it, then it is not a check of any kind. If you guys have conditions on you, like slow and that sort of stuff, go ahead and take those off. Any sort of permanent, quote-unquote permanent conditions, things that require rest to go away, they stay. So death saving throws do not reset, but like you're no longer slowed or other sorts of things. So so as you touch it, kind of draw a little bit of power from it, you feel this overwhelming sense of purpose kind of fall over you. Everything becomes very clear, very centered in what's going on. And you guys, everyone else can see a halo appear around Forrest's whole body that is generating radiant light in every direction. And there's a pretty potent form of radiant power coming from Forrest. So Forrest, until the end of the first round of combat, you can choose to deal radiant instead of any other damage type. If you do so, you get a +5 bonus to the damage.
Okay.
Armada?
I would like to second wind and move here to be in the middle of everybody. If that's possible.
Sure. Soroka.
I want to fix my cache.
Okay.
I was thinking in terms of trying to communicate with the being and give it a sense of peace and that everything's going to be fine, even though I know that in fact this soul is condemned and is going to be sent somewhere horrible. In order to get it to assist cache, I thought I would use bluff.
Okay.
That's a...
Sounds good. It's all okay. Don't worry about it. It's not okay.
It's all gonna be fine. Just fix the inside of the cache, please.
So the creature gives you a good bit of power to sort of seal up some of the cracks on the outside. You see the edges of the cache glow, and sort of the areas that are imperfections get melded into the rest of the glass orb.
And then we can position ourselves wherever we like.
If you're not binding to one of the caches, which you were not, you may position yourself wherever you'd like on the map. And I believe Meryl is last.
Yep, I'm going to go run over to the red cache and bind myself to it.
Gabriella, did you bind yourself to this cache?
Yeah, I did.
Okay, that's what I thought. I just wanted to double check. Because I didn't mark it because I'm dumb. Could you take... Is that aura is not until the end of the encounter, right, Meryl?
It's until end of the encounter.
Oh, it is. Cool.
But it's sustain.
Okay, which is fine. So, you guys can see the cache start to... The central cache start to glow and crack. Voices can be heard calling through it, and you guys can hear as the cracks continue to open on the outside of it, the little twinges of voices get louder and louder. And you can start to hear the booming voice of a great creature interacting with a very high-pitched crystalline voice inside of the cache. Those of you guys that are on the outside can see the cracks that are starting to open on the outside look like it's about to explode. Ophelia, you're up. You can tell if the cache is destroyed, then the soul contained inside is going to be deleted.
And it's the cache looks like it will explode soon. I would like to try to reinforce this with divine magic. So basically, at least postpone the cache from exploding, since that seems like what we're preventing from happening.
Okay, so go ahead and move adjacent.
And should I show a religion check?
Yes, please.
I don't have anything else left.
So, trying to figure out what it is, you really don't really know how this thing functions at all, and the kind of the religious orders or the religious knowledge doesn't really seem to help very much. You're kind of standing there thinking that there has to be some way to stop these cracks from forming or some way to interact with this, but you don't really know where to start. Gabriella, you're up.
I don't really know where to start either. I'd like to delay and hope someone else has an idea.
Felris.
Okay, so I will come closer. You said there are voices coming from the cache, right?
Yeah, through the cracks you can hear two fairly distinct voices, one that's loud and deep, and the other which is shrill and high-pitched.
Okay, so I have two things. I guess the thing I would like to do is, considering that I have this divine sense of purpose and all that, I'd like to, focus on those the worst cracks the weak points and channel that energy into those weak points to strengthen them.
Okay.
I think Tivriol perception like that would.
So work. Every time you touch, when you're kind of infused with the energy, every time you touch one of the cracks, you see it pretty much immediately close. And so if you can touch the right spots on the orb, you feel like you can do a pretty decent job of reinforcing it. AKA, yes, it would be a thievery. It would be an excellent choice.
Okay. So that's 49.
So you start to close in holes, and as you close one of the cracks, you hear the booming voice, and the shrill voice changes something and pauses for a second, and you hear the booming voice change and start to laugh. And then you feel the darkness in the orb starting to swell and pull, like something is drawing away from the orb. Armada.
Well, Falderas works on the actual orb. I would like to make certain that these look like there is something on the ground that is holding them in place so that they won't roll around in this room. So I would make certain that that thing is still working as intended. And if not, I would manually repair it and roll athletics for that.
Okay. So go ahead, go over to. Are you talking about the central cache?
Do I have others that look to be in worse condition?
I was curious, because there is one cache that is not bound to anyone, and I was just curious if that was something you were going to do or if you wanted to interact with this one.
I make point to stay in the middle of the group, so that is way too far for me to go there.
Okay.
But if any of the bound caches here in the middle look to be in worse condition than the black one, I would prioritize that one.
Gotcha. Sounds good. And no, they do not. This one looks in the worst condition. So give me probably a dungeoneering or an athletics check. Both of those would make sense to me.
Athletics, yes.
Soroka, you're up. So you stabilize the thing holding the orb into the place.
All right, I'm not exactly sure what we have left to interact with here. Are we still trying to deal with this central cache?
So the central cache is still damaged, and okay. You can see this swelling purple light that's coming from it. You can tell that something is coming this way. So you can either all prepare right. for what's going to be coming up next, or you can have a round to do something if you'd like.
Yeah. so I saw that Thalrus touched it, and it seemed to seal the cracks. So I'm just going to jump right onto it and touch every bit of it I can.
Okay.
A squashed blood on one shield. Yeah, my six arms, my four mandibles. It's a new definition for spread eagle. If an eagle had nine limbs.
So you kind of try to hold it together with basically just sheer force. Like, oh, it's breaking apart. Just belly flop on it and hold it back together.
I actually envision myself taking a very low altitude jump because there's a deadly zone above us.
Fair. You kind of slide it under the roof so you can land on top of it. You can see some of the cracks continue to close as you're focusing your time, your energy on it. It almost seems like rather than being a product of you actually closing it physically with your hand, that you will it into place, and when you touch it, it kind of understands what you're trying to do, and the orb responds by sealing some of the cracks. The light begins to suffuse the whole area and starts to get very, very angry, bright purple.
Is it possible? Does this thing work if it gets fed healing surges? Could I feed it a surge to strengthen it?
Yes, I would not have a problem with that.
We'll do that.
So, as you kind of push some of your life force into it, you get this weird glimpse. Your energy passes into the orb. and you get an image of two creatures locked in combat. One is an enormous blue dragon, and the other is an angel. I'm going to not really describe the angel so I can describe it when it pops out, sure. But you see this other creature, and then the creature notices you and starts to fly kind of towards you in the vision.
It's coming.
Meryl.
Okay, I'd like to run up to the middle thing.
Mm-hmm.
And could I try to calm down the soul on the inside with bluff and tell it that things are going to be fine so that it doesn't, you know, so that maybe the situation will be less volatile in there?
Okay. So you put your hand on the edge of the orb, you send that sort of goodwill in, and you see the dragon inside as this enormous figure, laughing and calling out taunts and insults in Draconic to the angel as it flees. And the angel redoubles its effort to speed out away from the dragon and to exit the cache to engage the rest of the group. And I believe, oh, sorry, Gabriella, do you have anything you would like to do?
Sure. Let's just join my vampire buddy and also be reassuring and nice, except that I actually mean it and will therefore be using diplomacy instead of bluff.
Gotcha.
Oh.
And sincerity is terrible.
Yeah, I wouldn't recommend. So the dragon, you know, also kind of gives you a nod as you get some sort of connection with the soul cache inside, and then things change. So the area all around the soul cache starts to glow with angelic runes. While you guys can't read Supernal, you can definitely recognize Supernal when it comes out. The entire area surrounding the soul cache fills with bright whitish purple light that then sends a column of energy straight up from the ground, pushing everything away as this enormous angel steps out of the cache in a column of purple light. I need for everyone to roll saving throws, please.
Of course.
So, if you succeed at the saving throw, you're pushed 3 squares away. If you fail the saving throw, you're pushed 3 squares up. So it looks like Armada and Meryl get thrown up. So, yeah.
Okay, against Armada.
Actually, wait. Heroic effort. I don't want to be in the Plague of Frogs.
Okay.
Okay, well, Meryl gets 34 damage. Anyway, does the angel get damage for entering my zone?
I will explain this as I explain how he comes out.
I assume so, I need to make the save.
You do indeed. So you get pushed 3 squares this way. Meryl, would you roll me a d10, please? Yes, you go directly away from the center. So Meryl, you take an extra 4 damage and land in that square prone.
And you have to be trained in acrobatics to try to land, right?
It also has to be willing. Jump from something willingly. So Soroka's there. Meryl, you're there and prone. This thing comes out. When it comes out, it does look like almost looks like a mockery of an angel. It has a hole where its face should be, and you can see on the interior these kind of writhing tentacles of black and radiant energy, or like necrotic and radiant energy, these black and white tentacles alternating. And as it kind of comes out, it stretches its wing into the Plague of Frogs, and you can see the effect sort of gnawing at the edge of the angel and washing over its weird coruscating armor. It appears to not care. So the angel gets out, looks around, and then goes, you hear this weird voice in your head. What are you doing here? This is not a means for mortal affairs. Get out! And the angel draws an enormous blade out of its armor and goes to turn towards you. So, in the Soul Cache handout, there is a new entry for you guys to look at. You guys will each get a recovery option. So, everyone here gets a single recovery option, and I want to explain this as quickly as possible. You can choose to get anything on the list. You can choose things on the list more than once. Everyone has an action point, I believe, at least one. You can use your action point to gain an additional recovery option. And yes, before you ask, if you have two action points, you can spend both of those action points to get extra action points that just don't count towards the limit of action points. I don't know why you would, but you can. You get a choice of whatever you would like to do. So you get one action, one recovery option, plus whatever else you would like. If you are bound to one of the soul caches, you get an additional one. So everyone gets two default, and you can spend an action point to get an extra one. And then, or everyone who's not Armada gets two default, and then Armada gets one.
Wait, so we can spend an action point to gain an action point?
Yes. I just said that.
Have we hit a milestone by now?
Yes, you have.
Cool. Well, that's basically a free refund of the action point to be able to use it again.
Yes, which is why I explained it explicitly.
Well, I'll be basically on skill challenge due to this encounter.
So what I'm going to do is remove everyone from initiative. I do need for you guys to re-roll me initiative as well.
Theory, so I'm sorry, I maybe didn't understand. We get, if we are bound to a cache, we get 2 points to spend?
Mm-hmm.
And just wondering, since we're hitting a milestone, if we spend one of our last current action point, we'd still have one for the battle, right?
I gave you guys two action points at the beginning of this. You haven't hit a second milestone.
Oh, okay.
You have you have an accurate number of action points currently.
Okay.
We have plus 5 to initiative, I believe, about how far that go.
It's 10 squares.
Okay.
So, Armada, did you pick the thing you get from the action recovery?
No, not yet.
Okay. Falrus, have you picked what you get from action recovery?
I will take the 5 for my stance and 1 to recover an encounter. And actually, I think I would get the second action point. Actually, no. I would.
I think
yeah, I would.
You wouldn't get an extra action point because whatever. So, you don't necessarily have to tell me what you're doing. I mainly want to know, have you made the choice yet?
Okay, I did.
Cool. Meryl, have you made your choice yet?
Yep.
Soralka, looks like you have. Gabriella?
Yep.
Ophelia?
I have.
Armada?
Now, do I need to spend my action point for a recovery to be able to spend two action points at,
If you wish to be able to spend two action points in this encounter, you need to use your recovery option to gain a second action point, yes.
Okay, cool. Then yes, I have chosen.
Cool. So, everyone, we need one more person for initiative, please.
Oh, me, sorry. also, stuff, doing stuff. Stall tactics. I may use that, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And spur to action. So anybody?
Here's the thing. Stall tactics? I guess it isn't role, so... Yeah, Okay, that would work.
And anybody who dislikes their initiative may reroll.
Oh, okay. I really dislike my initiative, so I won't.
I being one of them as well.
I don't think that matters, but yeah, okay. Doesn't matter at the moment, at least.
I lose 3 on the initiative.
Well, net sadness.
Alright, is everyone done doing their rearranging and being an initiative and all that sort of stuff?
Did everyone put their plus 10 to initiative?
What?
Did you include a plus 10 to initiative from Stall Tactics?
Yes. Yes, I did.
Oh, no. Let me do that.
Kill him, Miss Malls. He's killing me. Alright. So, surprising no one, the 50s will get to go first. Those of you guys that are in the blue are aware you're within an aura. Falrus, you're up.
Okay, so let me see. I'm going to move next to him.
So, also, the angel's body is covered in a sheath of writhing sand that you can see some of the essence of the creatures from the previous battle are protecting him.
That's not nice. Does moving next to him provoke something or something like that?
It does not.
Then I'm going to try and... Do I even want to do that? I will wait with that for the second turn. Let's go with flow slash on him. For a critical.
Good way to start the fight.
Yep.
So you get the little bit of backlash from striking into it as the Reaper's Cloak responds to you.
That's not nice. I'm going to do MBA against it as a... by the way, he's slowed. And I don't think I'm flanking with Lord Meryl. So that doesn't happen. Zero here. MBA against him, 33 damage. 33 AC versus 421 damage.
That'll 43 AC will definitely hit.
And I take 10 damage again, I believe. And let's see. Yeah, why not? I can do that anyway. That's a minor. That's standard would be a Path of the Blade. I believe I can only attack him once, because I can only attack, choose him as a first target once.
Mm-hmm.
That's a 31 versus his will.
Yep.
26 damage, and that's pretty much all, and minus 10 on me. And I can shift 8, but I think I'm going to stay where I am. Yep, that's all for me.
So you notice that you've destroyed most of the power that he gained from the angels as they died in the previous encounter. Gabriella, you're up.
I'm delaying till after Soroka.
Soroka, you're up.
I'd like to know if this thing is shadow or dead, although it looks like I probably don't know.
Don't know.
Okay. I'm going to turn in substantial. Going to go ahead and do this. What's called my weapons daily. It's going to let me do two MBAs and then shift. So, MBA number one.
Forty AC will connect.
Great, 18 damage. We'll prone it.
He becomes prone, and are you still using the weapon that slows and nonsense?
Yeah, the shadow weapon.
You realize that he is neither of those things.
Okay. Second MBA. 43 AC.
Yep.
I will add in sneak attack damage, so that'll do 29.
Okay.
I'm going to shift 1-2 when I enter it. I'm going to give it some acid damage of 4 or 5 points, I believe it is.
Okay.
We'll mark it.
Anything else?
Nope, I'm done.
Gabriella, he's now prone.
Okay, Falras, do you have a good Helm of Heroes power left?
Oh.
No, not really.
Damn. Does anyone have a good Helm of Heroes power?
If you go after me, I do, if I get up from prone.
It depends on what the cash gives me, is my answer to that.
Well, I guess I'll delay off to Ophelia to find out.
Okay, so Meryl.
Okay, I'm going to stand up from prone as a minor action, and I'm guessing I don't get to shift outside of my square, do I?
You do not.
Okay, I'll use my other minor to sustain. And then I am going to do Hungry Swarm, since I wasn't able to do it last battle.
Okay.
It's a lame roll.
What are the keywords on this attack?
Let me pull it up. One second.
Implement shadow teleportation. Okay. None that matter to me at the moment. But if you can, try to put the keywords in the macro at some point.
I can do that.
That does miss, unfortunately.
Okay, so he'll take 18 damage, and I will teleport and become invisible. And I guess I'll also regen.
Okay.
God, one second, sorry. I'm going to action point.
Do you want to play the game?
Actually, change it. I'm not going to action point yet. So that'll be it for me.
Ophelia.
I will teleport over here. It's a minor action to try to draw power from the cache, right?
If you're touching it, you don't have to. You have to take a minor action, but it does not take a check. But yes.
Okay, I try to draw power from it. What did I guess?
So you draw power from it. You feel the radiant aura around you completely wash away. And you get this very strong sensation like you're drowning all at once. And then after that sensation passes, you see little pot marks start to open on your armor as if you have been submersed in acid. Until the end of your next turn, you can change your damage type to acid. If you do so, plus 5 to damage rolls.
So I think a total of minus 2 if disable my radiant bonuses. Minus 2 damage.
Okay.
But that's better than doing 0 damage. I'll then charge into combat advantage.
For flanking with me, you have plus 1 to attack.
Not so at all. Nice. That's presumably a hit. Oh, I forgot the minus 2, so it should be 35 acid damage.
Mm-hmm.
And then I will action point and I will play Yuho's game, but I have to check the wording on one of my action point traits. One of this. Plus. Oh yeah, I can use it whenever. So yeah, I'll use Guidance of the Past in this. And I'll use your glow. +2 to attack. -2 to damage. That should be 4 higher, so it's 39 against Will.
39 against Will, we'll connect.
And he takes 21 seed damage.
Okay.
And then because of that hit, I get to make an MBA.
Okay.
And, oh wait, no. It's 1 to hit. -2 to damage. And that's 32 acid damage. And he has a red blobbin.
Anything else?
No, I'll end my turn.
Gabriella.
Okay, I will take my turn at last. Walk up to here, death from two sides, and Helm of Heroes, and I will take 17 from my dice.
Okay, I'll use... Is that to me?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll use glow.
You're using what?
Pure glow, because of Hell of Heroes.
How do you have there. Pure glow again?
Oh yeah, never mind. Then I will use. For some reason, I thought that it's Warlord's Recovery. I'm not sure why. Then I'll use just Well of Light. That also works. Oh, 30 versus AC is atrocious. I'll try to reroll that. I still have a Stone of Light up. I have two allies with stones, so that should be two higher. 32 versus AC, that it hit.
Which does not connect.
Oh god.
Damn.
So, well, 29 damage from Azriel, or from Gabriella?
I didn't. Did I use offer? I think I didn't use Offering of Blood this encounter yet. I used it only on the skill challenge, so I'll try to use that. Oh, this is much better. So that should connect for 81 damage.
Okay.
Okay, that makes me feel better. And I'll also then throw up Rising Sun for everyone other than Sorelka. And that will be my turn done.
Armada, you're up.
Did you say Sorelka?
Oh, everyone except you gets it,
yeah,
because
okay.
You are too far away.
I was confused. I was like, I don't think I'm...
What was the 10 damage prerequisite?
By the way, the cloak is going to hit you guys several times.
Yeah.
So, if I can...
Can you toss me the origin of the cloak again? Melee attack, I hit the dose 3 times, I believe.
Yep, Gabriel, you hit once, I think.
Yep, and then I healed it with Rising Sun.
HP. Cool.
Adjacency doesn't matter.
Adjacency does not matter. It's just melee attacks.
So what's the health situation of people here? So I'll move here. I'll give my last inspiring word to Ophelia, I guess.
Did you count the 10 healing after taking all the damage, Ophelia?
I did.
Okay.
There's the macro. I will... Guidance of the Past. A Lady Luck smiles at him.
And this group needs every reroll it can possibly get. You guys have fucking terrible rolls.
Yes, we do. Although 36 AC.
The 15 is, yeah, the 36 hits.
Okay, cool. I will soon give the aura. Then I will action point and use an item power. A captain's weapon.
So everybody adjacent to the creature adjacent to me can make a basic attack against him. If it's an MBA, they get a +2/+2.
Cool.
And you can reroll the attacks while you're in my aura.
I should try the crit fish. And the crit fish doesn't happen.
35 reflex hits for 32.
40 reflex for 40.
Dice that side.
And on this action point action, I will guidance of the past as well.
Man, power is killing me, man.
Yep, great.
The 33 on AC from my end, 12 damage.
Alras, you can reroll that.
Okay. That's good to know.
Because Lady Luck smiles.
Oh, that's a crit then.
Oh, crits are nice.
Also, yep. I'm a winner as well.
Actually, that's not a crit because my basic does not crit.
It's not a rogue
power. Yep.
Alright, I think I got all the stuff, and there's going to be a reaction thing, so let me know when you guys have finished resolving your attacks.
I have finished.
Yep.
Ezreal is bloodied. So he is going to howl with an otherworldly scream, attacking every soul cache in the room.
That's just rude.
So,
like to interrupt and take the hit.
Right. So yeah. If you guys would like to expend your interrupts in order to do this, and you actually have an interrupt to expend, you may do so. I think that's everyone but Armada, who does not have a soul cache at the moment. So, does the red one, does Meryl, do you take the hit for it?
Yeah.
Okay, 31 versus your fortitude.
Does he take the -5 from me being invisible to offset the +5, or the -5?
No, because it's a burst.
Gary, are you talking to yourself with the rolls?
I am talking to myself with the rolls, intentionally.
Oh, okay.
Because I can't, yep. I don't want to roll and then you guys get to choose. So, yellow. Faurus.
I will take it.
33 versus fortitude. Blue, Gabriella.
I will reluctantly take it.
35 versus fortitude.
Yep.
Soroka. That is 38 versus fortitude. This one gets automatically hit. Ophelia.
I'm taking it.
28 versus fortitude.
Of course, it's.
So those of you guys that got hit take 37 points of necrotic damage, and you are weakened and take a -2 penalty to saving throws. Save ends both.
I'm in substantial, so I'll take 18.
We have like a -6 total penalty to saving throw with the soil in his aura right now.
Yep.
Well, at least because he hit me, I get to make a saving throw right away, as I deal 5 acid damage. Oh wait, no, it's acid damage, so I don't get to make any saving throws. Because it's radiant damage.
Did my mark affect any of those attacks? Because I don't know how it's reworking it, Gary, but
yeah,
I had him marked.
He was marked, and you were included because you chose to take the attack. If you did not take it, it would have not done that. I don't think it would have mattered for missing anyone anyways.
I have one question and then I will end my turn. Did my 33 versus AC hit him?
The 33 versus AC, I counted up all the damage, I'm pretty sure that it did.
Question is if I take 10 damage.
Yes.
Okay, pass turn.
Ezreal's gonna go. So Ezreal begins his turn. Does any shenanigans happen to him when he begins his turn? It was some big burst thing, Soroka. Ow, that was loud. So there's a pure glow?
Yeah, he takes 10 AC damage if he starts his turn.
Okay. Okay. You notice that he doesn't take the damage, as if he resisted all of it.
Hmm.
He is then going to reach up with one of his wings and tap against Falrus. You see, yes, it was acid that he resisted. He taps against Falrus, and you see him disappear in a glimmer of light and reappear. He teleports to there. He teleports to here. Yes, he does. That's his movement action. You can see that he teleported adjacent to something, to another creature, when he did that. He is then going to use a burst. So he pulls up his weapon and cries out really loud. You guys feel your soul trying to react to his cry in Supernal as it tries to rip itself out of its body to follow the column of white and purple light that he sends into the air. So I need to roll extra attack rolls. So that's going to be 32 versus Falrus, 34 versus Meryl, 30 versus Gabriella, 29 versus a person whose name I can't see, Amrata, and then 28 versus Ophelia, two higher because of combat advantage, so 30 versus Ophelia, and then 32 versus Soroka. So if you get hit, 19 points of radiant damage, and you are dazed, save ends.
And is that the end of his turn?
Oh no, he's gonna action point.
Ah.
First thing he's gonna do is, I'm gonna make sure I'm not remembering this thing wrong. So, did he daze you? So, Soroka, are you weakened or dazed? It looks like you are weakened, correct?
I'm weakened.
Okay, so he is going to turn towards you, and you see in the hand that is not holding the blade, a hourglass appears that seems to be made out of some kind of crystal, and it starts to spin rapidly facing towards you.
That actually misses my will, thank goodness.
He is then going to use the action point action to swing at Soroka to start this off. So he takes the gigantic sword, and as he swings it towards you, you can see it flickers back and forth between being an enormous greatsword and being a scythe. Soroka, swing at you. 30 AC.
Misses.
Please make a death saving throw.
Failure.
So you have failed one death saving throw. He ends his turn. Well,
okay, I want to slide him back again next to me.
Okay.
And
at the start of his next turn, he would take 10 acid damage. You can see that he resists it. He's going to do the exact same thing again. And then he's going to take his first action is going to be to try to spin the hourglass again at Soroka. 26 versus your will, Soroka?
Checking. Yeah, it hits me right on.
You were stunned, save ends. He is then going to reap. So 39, 41 AC against Soroka.
That hits.
So 31 necrotic, and you fail the death saving throw.
I'm dead.
Swing and Falrus.
That's a hit.
So 48 points of damage.
And I'm unconscious.
Swing on Meryl.
That will miss.
And he is going to action point and swing on Meryl again. Actually, no, he can't action point twice in the same round, so he is done.
I'm going to slide him adjacent to me again.
Could you slide him away so we aren't all in the aura? Actually.
It has to be within two. I could leave him there, but I have to slide him to some other place in my aura.
Oh, okay, sure.
I was doing it so Day's people actually have something to do.
Yes, can you slide him up?
Okay, yeah, I could do that.
I'm saying, you could do that. You could slide him all the way to here. I don't know what your slide distance is.
It's two.
Two. So, one, two. He could be here.
I'd like him adjacent to me if possible.
Actually, hang on.
You could slide him in this way, so he might, you know, get away from me.
That works.
You can do that, or the main thing is that she can't slide you out of his aura, Tharus. I'm sorry, she can't slide the boss out of range of the aura. Which I think is the goal with what they were trying to do there.
Yeah, I can't physically. It has to be somewhere in my aura.
Tharus, you're up.
Okay, so I save at -4 versus the thing that gives me a -2 to saves.
Mm-hmm.
Because it only makes sense and it's a 0. At -4 versus the death. Another. And at -4 versus days, I believe, is the last one. That's nothing. Okay.
Soroka is removed from initiative because you're dead. Meryl, you're up.
Okay, I'm going to start off trying to save against Days because of Superior Will. I get a total of -6 against this, I think. So, 8. Oh, is it Charm, Fear, or Psychic by any chance?
Which one? The Days?
Yeah.
Let me double check. I don't think it is, but I'll click the thing that's the Burst, right? Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's this. Exaltation does not have those keywords, unfortunately.
Okay. So I just have my single action. Oh, I guess I do have action point. I'm going to start off with a Taste of Life on Azrael.
You're not certain what his life tastes like.
Okay, I'm going to action point and try again, because I need that buffer. It's not granting combat advantage, is it?
Not to my knowledge. He's also not marked, so there's that too.
Oh, ignore the saving throw, that was a misclick. Taste of Life. Actually, yeah, now that I think about it, I'm going to go ahead and try and, instead of Taste of Life again, I'm going to go ahead and do Castigating Strike.
Okay.
By the way, did you use Laid Luck?
Wait, what's that?
You roll twice and take when you do melee attacks while within the aura. While within the yellow aura, that's kind of hard to see. So roll a second d20 for the first attack, and then roll a second d20 for the second attack.
Oh,
so no, you definitely missed the first one. And you crit the second one.
Crit, I guess, will be 23 damage.
The crit will be 20. Why will the crit do 23?
Weekend, probably.
Oh, weekend. Gotcha.
And it's marked by me. And then that will be the end of my turn, and I'll make some saves. So, I'm going to try to save against the thing that gives me -2 to saving throws. Nope. I'm going to try to save against Dazed. Nope. And was the Weakened to Save Ends effect as well?
I do not believe so.
Okay. Then that will be the end of my turn.
Remember where the weekend is from. The weekend is from the bloodied.
Oh, I would have had a combat advantage because I am invisible, so an extra, I guess, 1 point of damage.
Okay. I'm going to click the macro again, not because it occurs again, because I don't remember what the thing is. And it is, yes. So it's weakened and -2 penalty to saving throws. Save ends both.
Okay, so it's the same effect. Okay. And that's my turn.
There's the effect again. Ophelia, you're up.
First, I'll try to Superior Will against Days. And I do superior will against the daze because I'm not in the aura. I don't get the minus 4, I only get the minus 2.
Okay.
How long does my acid damage thing last?
Until the end of this turn.
So I would kind of want to reapply it. I think I still have my daily teleport 6, but getting away from the party would kind of suck. Would I be still in the Naven Rage? No, I would not. In that case, I'll have to improvise. I'll try to RBA him. Actually, for my minor action, I will use Rising Sun. Fulrus, you can stand up. Everyone can regain 12 HP. Rather, Fulrus, you'll still be prone, but you are at 12 HP at least.
Yeah. Okay.
He's better than zero.
Yep, thanks.
My move action, I'll teleport somewhere where I'll just teleport to get my defense bonus up, but I'm not entering the damn aura. And I'll try to RPA him. I do not have combat advantage, I believe.
Don't think so.
And I have minus 2 to damage because I'm using acid. And that's a horrible miss, and I'm all out of rerolls. End of turn.
What about
the Lady Luck?
Lady Luck?
Oh, yeah.
You're not out of rerolls.
That's one.
Now you're out of rerolls. And that does miss, unfortunately. Not by a lot, but it does miss. Gabriella, you're up.
Okay, Superior Will. I'm going to... I think I have to go for the super risky one. Necklace of Prayer Beads to give everyone a saving throw. And I will try to save off the daze again. And fail. Damn.
Oh, I'm not taking time.
Well, that will end my turn, so I'll save against the save penalty. And the daze. Yay. And the... Wait, that was the only ones. Okay. I'm done.
Armada, you're up.
First, rousing words on Fulrus. extra 0 hit points. Correct. Congratulations.
Well, at least it's 2 healing surges.
So, as you spend your healing surge, Fulrus, you see the those writhing tentacles in the face of Ezreal reach out towards you.
That will hit.
So it is a ranged attack, so it will provoke.
Okay.
But everyone adjacent is dazed.
Yeah, I'm
dazed. Yeah, I couldn't... Well, yeah, I guess this person is dazed. I couldn't see whether Meryl was dazed. So you take 7 points of radiant necrotic damage and you're weakened until the end of your next turn.
Okay.
So you heal first and then take damage. Usually not relevant, but go ahead.
Double checking what were my 2 standard actions. Because I am going to move next to him, I am going to stand the fall, and I am going to take another. Wait, yes. I will need to enable Fulrus. Fulrus, do you want to take a melee basic or a ranged basic?
I'm prone, so I'm not sure I'm the best person to.
Okay, Ophelia, take a ranged basic.
Okay, this will be force damage. So I have a minus 7 to damage because it's force instead of radiant. Which I included, so it's 27 force damage.
Did you roll again? Would you like to roll again? Would you like to not roll again?
Alright. I constantly forgot that Lady Luck smiles at me.
So 27 damage?
Yeah, 27 force damage. If it matters, so that is a force. That is force.
It only matters that it's not radiant or necrotic.
Okay. By the way, Gary, does this one still have 2 hit points, or does it have 1 hit point?
It should have 1, sorry.
I probably hit him for 23 damage, and everybody spends surges and take bonuses appropriately, and I will need to see what I get. You get something. That's the thing. 7 temporary hit points for everybody within 5, and pass turn.
So, close enough. Close enough to this one. No. Close enough to that one. Don't I? Yeah. So he kind of gestures around with his weapon at you guys that are around his base, like he's sort of confused and annoyed that you're causing him problems. He is then going to swing his weapon as a minor action towards the soul cache that you are bound to, Faurus. Would you like to take the attack with the soul cache?
I'm dazed.
Ah, this is true. So, he is going to do this.
Obliterate doesn't sound fun.
And destroy one of the pieces of the soul cache. He is then going to teleport to here. And then he is going to begin reaping. Meryl, did you mark him? I wasn't listening. I don't think so, because you didn't have an action. Okay.
I did, because I did a Cascading Strike, and that marks.
Right. What was your question, Ophelia?
No, never mind.
So he fades into shadow and pops out of Armada's soul, and then begins to reap. So the reap will start with Meryl. Uh, 28 AC on Meryl. 30 AC because of Daze.
That will miss.
He will spend his remaining action point and do that again.
Okay, so let me make my death saving throw, I guess.
Yeah, so.
That will fail.
And reap. One higher, so 31 AC.
Will miss.
So make a save.
That will pass.
Barely.
He ends his turn. He is going.
I can't do shit.
He's going to. He's not close enough to this one. Is he? No. Did I fail at teleportation? I did fail at teleportation. That is the saddest of days. So yeah, he will teleport to here. Actually, no. He'll just shift down one because what the hell? Why not be in range of multiple things? Still not in range of multiple things because I'm bad at being able to judge distances. So he will obliterate down on the one that Ophelia.
I will take the attack.
33 versus AC.
Miss. My AC is 37 right now.
Is that including the minus 5 you get for intervening?
Oh, that's not included. I thought that you included it.
I'm not including it on mine because there is a way to mitigate that. So,
okay. Then that's
total 38. So, 13 points of necrotic damage, and you lose a healing surge.
13 is exactly my resistance to necrotic.
So, you don't take any damage, but you lose a surge. He is then going to reap. So, reap on Meryl. Miss.
That misses.
Moment of truth.
Boom.
Nice. And he doesn't have another action point to spend, nor does he have any other actions, so he's done. Faurus, you're up.
Okay, I finally saved against the minus 2 saves, so that's good. So, superior will against the Daze. And I don't. That kind of sucks because
I'm... You
can
crawl charge.
Oh my god. I believe...
By the way... Oh yeah, never mind.
Knockout is only on the melee, so that will suck as well. You know what? I can crawl over to him. That will be my action and action point.
Okay.
And from crawling, I will use knockout. I will use the 15 from the dice.
Yeah, okay.
And yep.
I'm sorry, the mental image of like you crawling up to the angel who's flying above you and just like poke him in the foot and knock him out. It's beautiful.
Yep. That's it. That doesn't really matter here, but in here. Great.
When sadly, do not crit, but so yep. 37 damage.
I'm weakened, so that's half.
So 16?
No, that's more than 16, I believe.
That's 18.
18. And he falls unconscious, save ends. If he takes damage, it will end. But yeah, that is the end of my turn, and I get two saving throws, I believe.
I'm gonna delay till after Ophelia.
Go ahead, Ophelia. One second. Pause. So if you're starting your turn and you have conditions that trigger off at the start of your turn, Ophelia, those happen before you delay. So, for example, Superior Will happen before you choose to delay. So do that first.
Oh, okay. I'll do my Superior Will then. That will fail.
Okay. Carry on.
Yeah, I'll teleport. I'll try to...
Either you're cutting out or you're not using words.
I'm trying to come up with something that doesn't do radiant. On my character, that's not very easy. I think I can coup de grace with a ranged attack, right?
You can coup de grace with a ranged attack as long as you're adjacent, yes.
Okay, so that's my best option here.
How much damage is that there?
I think they're trying to. it doesn't matter because you nat one.
Is Lady Luck Smile still up?
Is gone now.
It's gone.
Oh yeah, that's zero damage.
Yes, you miss an unconscious creature next to you. Anything else, Ophelia?
At least he doesn't wake up.
I will use a minor action to sustain my Rising Sun, which means Gabriella can heal. Let me check how much, I don't remember off the cuff. Gabriella can heal 7 points. And I end my turn.
I'm gonna delay till after Armada, because I'm not gonna be the one to wake him up, because I do shit damage now.
Gabriella?
Yeah, and I'm weakened, so I do 0 damage as well, but we need to take the coup de grace at some point. Armada, do you do good damage?
No.
he might lose a turn because of that, and better than giving him 15 damage would be for him to
Fair
lose
enough.
A turn.
Okay, then I guess I will also just delay until, well, after he wakes up or misses both of his turns if we're really lucky.
So, Gabriella, Meryl, and Armada, three of you guys, are you choosing to delay until after he takes his first turn?
Yep.
Okay. So, he is going to begin his turn. So he is no longer unconscious, but he cannot take standard actions. So what is he going to do? Without standards, he's going to stand up as a... He is going to lifelink teleport to here as a movement action. And actually... Damn it, I'm bad at range. Oh well. He'll lifelink teleport to there instead. And then he is going to use Obliterate on Ophelia's Soul Cache.
I intercept it.
It's going to be, including the penalty, is going to be a total of 37 AC.
Which is... I think I lost my bonus, so my AC is 35 right now.
So, 17 necrotic damage, and you lose a healing surge.
Who needs healing surges?
I think... Let me double check to make sure I'm not crazy. Can't... Oh, he needs a roll to see if he can get that. He does not have that yet. Yeah, that's all he can do for his first turn, without without having actions. Gabriella, you're up.
Okay. Ophelia, oh wait, you don't have a reasonable MBA anymore.
I have only an RBA.
Yeah, which doesn't do a huge amount of damage.
Well, it's...
I mean, it's just not much better than me attacking is the thing.
Yeah, fair enough.
Although I'm weakened, so yes it is, never mind. Okay, I guess I'll just direct the strike so you can make your attack.
Do you want to move away from provoking before that?
Oh, it is... Right, yeah, well, I was going to provoke anyway this turn, so... Okay. No.
Okay.
I will do my RV.
So he's going to... You're violating Mark, so he's going to take the provoke first. He is not marked, so he's going to swing at Gabriella. 26 AC on Gabriella.
That will miss, and I was really hoping that wasn't the basic attack, because I'm dead. Yep.
Okay, Ophelia, 33 reflex definitely connects. I assume that damage is correctly appropriated.
Yeah, it's correct.
Meryl, it's your turn.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and Domineering Gaze. Damn it. Okay, and then I'm going to make some saves.
That hits. I mean, if you don't want it to hit, you don't have to.
No, so. I do want that to hit. Okay, cool, sweet. Then I'm going to make some saves. save against the penalty to saves.
You stare into the hole where his eyes would be.
Sweet. And then I'm going to save against the days. Boom, no more days.
Armada.
Repeat. I will move. And Commander Strike with Ophelia.
I don't have an MBA, just saying. He's immune to the damage type of my MBA, so...
I'll direct the strike, then move. And... So take an RBA then, he's dominated, so he should not be able to take an attack.
Correct.
I had a minor action left, yes, I will... Use that to do weird things. Shadow myself. And I'm out of action, so pass turn.
Asriel begins his turn. He's going to attempt to get rid of the Dominate. He does not get rid of the Dominate. What is he doing?
Okay, so who all of us has some... Well, hell. I'm going to have him run back and forth and provoke MBAs from...
He should probably just... I'm just saying, Falras is dazed, you guys are all weakened, and he's immune to my MBA. He should probably just make himself.
Yeah, that works.
If you could get him out of, you know, range of me, I might be able to save against dazed and actually be useful on my turn.
Okay, so should I have him run and provoke from me and Armada and finish his turn so Falraz is outside of Ezreal's aura?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to do that. I want him to run up and around so he provokes from me as well.
Okay. He has 22 squares of movement, so...
can you put him
not that far, dear somewhere, God, not that far.
Somewhere where I can reach him with a charge.
Yeah.
So where you guys are just outside of the aura, like that?
Yeah, that looks good.
I'm not... okay. Never mind. Carry on.
And actually just let Armada take the aura, because my shit does radiant. Or, yeah, let Armada take the attack.
So when he goes to fly away, you become aware that he has a trait called Angelic Purpose that if he only takes, I didn't actually macro it in because it's kind of irrelevant, but if he only takes movement actions on his turn, it doubles his movement speed.
Oh, okay.
I hit for 16 damage and lose my temps.
He does not have the Creeper's Cloak on him anymore. He is now bloodied.
Oh.
Is bloodied, so you do not take damage if you attack him. And he will end his turn, dominated. Taurus, you're up.
Okay, now let's see if I can save. Of course not. Okay. Well, this went in a very horrible way. Yeah, I have nothing better to do than throw a bloodbath on him. Come on, advantage. That's a yes, but at minus 2. Sure, yeah, that's a 0 in here. Let it hit 30-40 with it.
That's gonna have to ask me ask. So you're taking the minus 2 for long range and the minus 2 for being prone, correct?
No, I only took it once, so 28. What do you?
So unfortunately, 28 is gonna miss.
28 is going to
is
miss.
Is that including combat advantage?
Yes.
It is.
Well, that's. Yeah, that's all. He takes 23 damage from the effect, and I save against the dice. Yep, finally.
Ophelia.
I'll begin by teleporting here, I'll grab some acid, and I'll charge.
Alright. Is the damage correct?
Yeah, it's correct. And that's the end of my turn.
Ezreal, you are being annoying to him, so he is going to attempt to reap you.
Is he going to try to save?
Still dominate?
Oh, right. Yeah. He is still dominated. And he succeeds, but he can't reap because he does not have that action. He is going to obliterate on the soul cache, I think? Yeah. Gabrielle is dead, so can't do anything about that, so we'll obliterate on that soul cache as a minor action. Nobody dazed or weakened? I don't think so. Oh,
I'm weakened.
You're weakened? So he's going to hourglass at you. This does provoke, so Ophelia, you're... Oh, no, it's not. It's melee. So he can't do that. He would have to lifelink. So he's going to lifelink to here, and then he's going to swing. So
is his lifelink a move action? Or
lifelink is a move action, yes.
So wouldn't he... Oh... Does he lose a standard action, or is he just not able to take standard actions?
He just can't take standard actions.
Okay.
So, it's the same effect that you were affected by earlier.
35 will, in fact, hit me.
Your stun save ends.
Armada, can you please bond that one, or it will die, and all of our undead will experience horrible, horrible fates.
Ezreal ends his turn. Gabriel, you're up. Oh, sorry, Gabriel is dead. Meryl, you're up.
Okay, I'm going to try and superhero will. No. Yeah, that's, well, at then the save's at the end of my turn. I'm going to try and now save against my stunned at the end of my turn. Or actually the minus two saves first.
Okay.
Nope, and then the stun. Nope.
Armada.
Okay, so... I guess what I'm doing is
please
gonna be...
bond.
Yeah, yeah. shift one. Minor action. Plead the cash to lose its bond on Gabriella and accept me as the new host. Diplomacy.
Okay. And that will be enough for success. It is now bound to you.
And then I'll just slap him with a melee basic, I suppose. probably a miss, and next player can go.
That is a point of fact, a miss, unfortunately. Ezreal. Doesn't have any bad things on him, doesn't have any reason not to reap. First action he's going to do is obliterate. Armada, do you want to take the shot for the cash?
Yeah.
that's a hit. 13 necrotic damage, you lose a healing surge. He is then going to reap on Meryl, and let's see if Meryl's got the saving throws for days. Because I'm going to miss.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
For days. Nice. Ezreal's done. Valros, you're up.
Okay, let me see. I will stand up and throw a slight flourish at him. I don't really see any better option, and he doesn't have combat advantage. Yep, it kind of sucks. For 31 versus AC.
That'll hit.
27 damage, and yep, I don't really have minors at this moment, so that's all.
Ophelia.
Move action to teleport here, minor action to refresh acid, standard action to charge.
Okay.
Everything should be correct.
Oh, is it actually 35?
Yes, it's absolutely correct, 35.
Okay. He looks like he has a stiff wind would knock him over.
Well, unfortunately, I already used my Blackguard thing in the last encounter.
Alright, so Ezreal will begin his turn. He'll obliterate on the soul cache. Well, no, he can't use it on that one. So he's not in range of that. Sure, he'll do that. He'll lifelink teleport to here. And obliterate on Meryl's cache.
Yeah, I can't do shit about it, so go on ahead.
That's right, because you're stunned. So that one goes down to one. And then he is going to turn and reap on Amandra and kind of go down the line. Armada, Amandra, whatever. Armada. Armada, 35 AC.
It hits.
39 and fail the death save. Ophelia.
He get 5 acid damage, if he cares about it.
5 acid damage from White Lotus?
Yeah, from White Lotus.
Describe your kill.
There's this aura of acid protecting me from the cache. As he tries to strike at me with his scythe, the aura... he pretty much burns himself against the aura, not expecting it to be... as strong as it was. And he just melts while trying to attack me. Something like that, since that's pretty much how it went.
So the angel crumples to the ground, the soul cache clears and comes to be another one of those kind of coruscating colors that everything else looks like. Instead of being the dark kind of purplish black color of it being corrupted. You see a little functionary, one of the Doom guides, kind of poke his head around the corner. You're like, that was... Oof. I think I'm supposed to take you all to see the Seneschal. And he will lead you all, including the dead ones, up to go and see Jergal. Jergal congratulates you in his own way, where he looks up and says, "Against all odds, you did not fail. I shall denote this in the book."
User was moved out of your channel. User joined your channel.
He looks up at you, and then he allows the pen to continue writing on its own and says, "Those of you all that failed in your duties to remain alive, however, that was not part of the bargain, but I can see these names appearing in my book should not continue forward." He waves his hand at the book, and you see the people that died in the adventure, Soroka and Gabriella, take a bit of a deep breath as they wake back up. He looks down at the book and says, "You do not belong here in this city. You are nominally alive. At least each of you pretends to be as such. Leave." And he continues to write. So, if you were brought back from Jergal, you do not suffer normal raised dead penalties, as Jergal doesn't use a ritual to bring you back. He just sticks your soul back into your body and tells you to leave. In order to facilitate your leaving of the fugue plane, they do not give you the time to go in rock crossroads or link portal or anything like that. The Doom Guides lead you to an area in the Temple District where you're able to step back directly through a linked portal that will take you back directly to the guild. So if you're a DM, if you could go non-peasant mode so we can get loot stuff taken care of.
I'll open the tables in a moment.
I've already got them up. I had some time.
Okay.
Sorry, Ryan.
Never mind.
So the first thing you guys get, all of you earned an asterisk in Death's notebook. You guys will also gain Executor of the Just.
It's a bit hard for me to keep track of as I'm reloading. I'm sorry.
That's fine.
Oh, you guys did save all the cash.
Yes, they did. So, go ahead and look through the story awards. If you have any questions about the story awards, by all means ask.
Oh god, that's Are some of those story awards specific for those who died or survived or something like that?
None of the story awards are specific for people depending on their state of life or unlife at the end of the adventure.
Okay.
In sort of meta explanation-wise, you did not actually die because, while yes, you died, Jergal didn't write your name in the book because he didn't want to. And so he just sort of paused in writing your name and then gave you your souls back.
Sprinting up to 4 healing surges on death save sounds nice.
So this doesn't sound like anyone has any questions.
My questions are